Listen, for the angel of this amazing conference, give God praise. But Dr. Bird, come on, lose your mind for 30 seconds. Come on, Dan, 30 seconds. I need you to lose your mind for at least 30 seconds for great leadership. Come on, give God praise for great leadership. who feed us and lead us, God. They watch by our souls, God. So I got to shout out of your mouth and say something about great leadership. Listen, and while you're praising him, you got praise for Lady Bird. Come on, go praise him. Come on. Ladies, praise. Depending, what can we say about you? I can't wait to hear you. The last time we were together, I felt like getting saved all over again. So tonight, I'm really nervous. But Dr. Bird, I didn't bring my $1 million check. My parents always told me you never come in the presence of a king and a queen without bearing gifts. So I left my $1 million check, but I brought y'all some music. Is that okay? Can you give God praise for one more time? No speeding ticket commission. I'm going to hurry up and get out of the way. I've been on the road. This is probably the sixth concert or so in the next few days, so I feel like I got to get saved all over, so I got to get some word in me. But I want to just say that I'm so honored, Dr. Birch, to be back here. That means I've done something right. I feel like when you come to Grace 2 years in a row, you can just go on to be with God. You can just go on to glory. Ain't nothing else to do after this. Amen. But I got a song that I prepared for you guys, and I almost don't want to do this song based on the atmosphere that's in this room. I kind of want to change the song.
What you want to do?
Huh? David the floor, huh? You and C-Sharp? Listen, we had all of this crazy tragedies and things of that nature happening, shootings and killings and injustices. But I'm determined that what I'm going to do is I'm just going to draw nigh unto God and allow God to draw nigh unto me. How many worshipers realize that, listen, when God's glory and his power and his anointing and his favor is upon you, I don't care who pulled you over. When you pull me over and ask to see my credentials, you're going to see and sense such an anointing of God's presence. You're going to do right by me. Every worshiper, just help me saturate this atmosphere with worship and make it conducive for your miracle, because that's a spirit of fear that's trying to get the body of Christ. But listen, some can trust in horses and some can trust in chariots, but I trust in the living God who's able to keep me against any evil day. Every worshiper, this is what we need upon our lives to protect us. I need you, Lord. I want you. Of you is what I found out of need. This one, my daily prayers. Somebody's breakthrough. Is he still on the throne?
Serve thee.
Yeah.
And Nahash the Ammonite answered them, On this condition will I make a covenant with you, that I may thrust out all your right eyes and lay it for a reproach upon all Israel.
Yeah.
And the elders of Jabesh said unto him, give us 7 days respite, that we may send messengers unto all the coasts of Israel. And then if there be no man to save us, we will come out to thee. Then came the messengers to Gibeah of Saul, and told the tidings in the ears of the people. And all the people lifted up their voices and wept. And behold, Saul came after the herd out of the field. And Saul said, what aileth the people that they weep? And they told him the tidings of the men of Jabesh. Verse 9 calls they, and they said unto the messengers that came, thus shall ye say unto the men of Jabesh Gilead, tomorrow by that time the sun be hot,
my God,
ye shall have help.
Yeah.
Want you to turn to somebody and tell them, say, hey, hey, hey. In case nobody told you.
In case you didn't know,
I am the help.
I am the help.
Come on, turn to somebody else and tell them, I am the help. You will find us.
I am the help.
We are gathered here today to get through this thing and to unravel and unveil the manipulative attacks of the enemy. His principal goal is to render the church and her people powerless with his persistent attempts to pummel it down in spite of the eternal promise of Jesus Christ concerning the church. Matthew 16 and 18, where he declares, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against
it.
Reminding us that we simply cannot lose. But notably, he preys on the strengths of those he's targeted, the anointed and the purposed one. Not their weaknesses, but their strengths. Because the one thing Lucifer knows is that in our weakness, his power is made perfect.
All right.
What he is hopeful of is that he can obliterate your vision, kill your dream, blur, dim, and distort what others see in us and what we see in ourselves that has not yet come to pass. He wants to disable our ability to create, influence, focus, and unite. Why is this? Because if after all that he can get you to go through trial and cause you to doubt the power of unity within the body of Christ and forget the power that lies within you, then he believes he can kill the devil.
All right.
What he needs to understand is that one day after we've endured for a while, you realize that the problem really is the devil doesn't understand that you are, in fact, the help. The one thing that I have come to understand is that the enemy is being more divisive in this season. Not just in the church, but politically. As a nation, his whole objective is to intimidate and to embarrass those that God has called for such a time as this. If he can humiliate you and make you feel like what God has promised is not going to happen, then he has already won half the battle. Forgot one thing. He forgot that he that hath begun a good work shall until the day of Jesus. Tell somebody that means I got power until he comes. That means I can't fail. I might weep, but I won't fall down. I might cry, but I won't die. I might. I wish I had somebody in here.
Right.
What?
They have the tendency to that though he came from Lot, he was still not pure Israeli.
Yeah.
There are a lot of people that, I just gotta be honest, they hate you because they hate you. Yeah. I know that sounds very cliche, but I'm telling you, there is an identity.
Yeah.
preach in that bridge some years before. And he goes all the way back to Judges 19. He will have to read the Chronicles of Judges 19 through Judges 21 to find what he can to infiltrate and bring another launch of attack. This one has to work. He finds that in Judges 19 through Judges 21, that there was a Levite who had a concubine. And they went to his family's house in Bethlehem. After staying there for a few days, they decided that they would go to a place called Gibeah. Gibeah is a place that was much inhabited by the Benjaminites. And it was there that an old man offered them lodging for the evening. Because this Levite and this concubine had decided that they were going to go and live their lives away from everybody else. Let me see if I can help you. It was a preacher and his prostitute. He wanted to get somewhere away from everybody else so that he could live his life like his own.
Being more and more adamant about him being put out there, he takes the concubine and pushes